What's up guys, this is Srivin here from Yumi and Tech. Welcome to our latest video. We have been using the new Oppo K3 as our daily driver from past 3 weeks and I feel it's time for a detailed review. So should you buy this phone or not? Please watch our video till the end to find out that. And before we get into the video, don't forget to like our video, share our video and subscribe to our channel. And also press the bell icon to get all our content without any delay. So let's jump into the video. We will keep this review as simple as possible so that any common man can decide should they buy K3 or not. We will definitely make sure not to bombard you guys with tons of specs and technical terms as half of them does not matter at all. And what really matters is, are you happy with the phone or not? So let's divide this review into two parts. Number one, what we liked. Number two, what we did not. Or what could have been better. So let's see what we liked about Oppo K3. As you know, we have the jet black model and aesthetically it looks very, very attractive. The dark green and black gradient color is pretty unique compared to the regular blue and red gradient colors from the competitors. The Oppo logo, dual camera setup, flashlight positioning, designed by Oppo tagline, all looks like it's inspired from the big brother flagship Oppo Reno, and definitely it looks dope. The phone is pretty heavy and thick, but still the round corners and the curvy edges makes it easy to hold. K3 comes with a polycarbonate back, but that does not mean it feels cheap. As a whole, K3 feels very, very premium, and one drawback of the plastic back is definitely it is more prone to scratches. And one thing that we did not enjoy about the phone is that it is a fingerprint magnet. So we definitely recommend you to use a case if you are planning to use K3 for a long term. Oppo makes this easier by providing a hard case in the box, thanks to Oppo. So overall, build quality and the design gets a thumbs up. On-screen fingerprint scanner. Using the on-screen fingerprint scanner has been very smooth experience. It did not disappoint us at all. It's very fast, always accurate, very conveniently positioned and very easy to access too. Oppo also provided face unlock feature, which is equally fast, but I did not use it much as the on-screen fingerprint scanner was always the best option, and also the face unlock failed to perform well in low light situations, so fingerprint scanner gets a thumbs up. Display. In my opinion, one of the best features of K3 is definitely the 6.5 inch Super AMOLED display. K3 comes with a full screen display without any notch or punch hole setup, and it offers you a 91.1 screen to body ratio, which is rare in this price category, which means K3 offers you a very immersive multimedia experience. The colors are so punchy, blacks are so deep, great viewing angles. Watching movies and playing games on K3 is a treat to your eyes. K3 also comes with HDR video support, which is an added advantage. Performance. With 8GB RAM and Snapdragon 710 chipset, using the phone is a flawless experience. Throw anything at K3, it runs like a charm. RAM management is pretty good. Multitasking is great. It can keep as many as apps in the memory without any trouble at all. And for gamers out there, K3 is a beast for gaming. PUBG runs with high graphics settings by default. And I have spent many hours without even a single stutter or frame drop. Adding on to that, Oppo's Game Space app and features such as Frame Boost and Touch Boost makes needed changes to run any game in the best way possible. Quick charging. 3765 mAh battery is not a game changer at all. It is just good enough to get you through a day of moderate usage. And we were able to get a screen on time of 4 hours on an average basis. But what sets K3 apart is the quick charging. Oppo's VOOC 3.0 20-watt charger makes up for the average battery life. It is so fast. Around 30 minutes of charging will get you 50% of battery full on the Oppo K3. That means whenever you feel short of battery, just 20 minutes of charging will get you through any critical situations. Another cool feature of K3 is that it can deliver Dolby Atmos sound through the headphone jack. And I found this to be very, very impressive, especially for gaming and better movie experience. But this feature is only available through the headphone jack. That means Dolby Atmos is not supported in case of Bluetooth earphones, which is slightly disappointing as everyone is switching to Bluetooth earphones in this era. So let's see what could have been better with Oppo K3. Camera. Straight away, I can say that those who want to purchase a phone for the best mid-range camera, this is not the one for you. I'm not saying that camera performance of Oppo K3 is very bad, but definitely it's not on par with the best in the mid-range segment. We can take pretty good pictures with 16 megapixel rear camera sensor in bright light or in good lighting conditions. But as the lights turns out to be not so good, K3 camera starts to fail. It's a clear hit or miss in the low light conditions. There is a night sight mode, but that also does not seem to be much helpful. And of course, there is portrait mode to create the background blur and smooth skin tone. But that too, I find far from perfect. Skin beautification looks very artificial and the background blur does not look good in most of the occasions. The 60 megapixel selfie camera is a good addition to avoid notch or the punch hole display. And it's also good for very fast and eye candy face detection feature. But it really fails in the core functionality, which is to take crisp pictures. I feel most of the photos are overexposed and it gives a washed out look to most of the pictures. Getting a good dynamic range is very difficult with the front facing camera. Compared to the selfie cam, I feel the rear camera works far, far better. You can shoot 4K video with 30 frames per second with Oppo K3. The videos are acceptable. Video stabilization is pretty good. And there are some overexposure issues with the video, but that can be managed. All these issues related to the camera are based on the software. If we can get a pretty stable Google Cam mode or a good third-party camera app, I believe these issues can be resolved pretty easily. The ColorOS. This may not be a con for all of the users, but yes, those who are the fans of stock Android, definitely it's an improvement point. ColorOS has come a long way through the past years and now we have ColorOS 6.1. It has its own look and feel. The cartoonish icon and animation has improved a lot. Still, the fluidity that the stock Android UI gives is missing with the ColorOS. And we could also find some minor bugs in the UI too, especially when we are using Google Photo app. So those who like to use stock Android UI, we would recommend using a launcher for that. So I've been using Nova Launcher for the same purpose and I'm pretty happy with the results. So how we can conclude? I believe for an ideal smartphone, there are 5 pillars. Number 1, the build quality. Number 2, the display. Number 3, the battery performance. Number 4, the phone performance. And number 5, the camera. So if you assess with that, the Oppo K3 has a great build quality and the display of Oppo K3 is gorgeous, and the phone performance as a whole, it's flawless. The battery performance, the quick charging is awesome, and only place where Oppo K3 lags behind is in terms of camera. So if you are somebody who is looking to buy a smartphone only for camera, stay away from Oppo K3. But if you are looking to get a smartphone with exceptional build quality, performance and multimedia consumption for gaming, for movie watching experience, this is the phone for you. As we all know, mid-range devices are getting better, better and better day by day. And I can clearly say that Oppo K3 is one among the best phones that you can buy in this mid-range category right now. So what do you guys feel about the Oppo K3? Let us know your decision and your opinions in the comment section below. And if you end up liking this video, don't forget to like our video, share our video and subscribe to our channel. And I'll be coming back with more and more unboxing and review contents very, very soon. Till then, bye.